Hello, Edward Snowden. It's 17 December 2013, Desiree here. I need to upgrade you and I need to warn you. Let's start with an upgrade. You are unaware of it, but the Dutch parliament can collapse this week. If we get new elections, PVV Geert Wilders can be president. 16% of the people think he is the most favorite politician of the year. You never know how it ends in the Netherlands, but it's such a tremendous chaos that all predictions are worthless. Whether we talk about political situations or economics or espionage or justice, everything is unpredictable at the moment. And now it's imploding. That means that the lobby platform behind the International Criminal Court is growing in violence. And I shall give you a very good example. We have a Dutch lawyer, he is famous, his name is Geert-Jan Knoops, International Criminal Law. He works officially for the International Criminal Court. And he also organizes mass murder via ICC and he misuses me for it. In the Netherlands, he does not live by the constitution, the lawyer's law we have, and the international human rights treaties. He knows ICC has proven to me that they refuse to conduct the Statute of Rome. Thus, being a Dutch lawyer, he is obliged to take the torture treaty and to inform the Dutch people about the true corruption between ICC, politicians, universities and the court. He refused to do so, and that's because he is famous. As you know, both Russia and China are not state members of ICC. And they both misuse ICC as a cover for their personal war crimes. What they do is they increase mass murder, each on their own merits. China has now invited the Dutch lawyer Geert-Jan Knoops to be a professor at the Shandong University in China. That meaning in daily life, in reality, that China is going to blackmail organizations and politicians via the lobby system behind the International Criminal Court. And they use that lawyer Knoops for it. Knoops will be a kind of double spy or even contra spy. Thus the lobby platform expands and expands via the universities, the bar association, etc. I don't know if you have noticed it, but the Russian Bar Association has sent me a very insane email. They sent me two emails, as a matter of fact. I think I only published one on newlegalframe.com. They call me names. Well, I warned them for the fact that the current methods of work of Putin cause a civil war in Russia. They know who I am, of course, and they call me names. Well, I have published that email, so everybody knows that the Russian Bar Association is, of course, just as criminal as the Dutch or the International Bar Association. But that they are violent and they... Wait. That they... are causing war sneakily behind the back of the Kremlin. So Putin doesn't even know, unless I tell him. I give Putin all kinds of information. He is not worth it, because Putin is a mass murder builder. He wants more mass murders, and he wants more victims to be lawless. The man is really a danger for the country. I don't know yet how FSB or the Kremlin will respond to the fact that the Russian Bar Association torments me, because it's of a huge impact internationally in the way of doing business. And whether we talk about space, technology, health, oil, is irrelevant. When bar associations start to torment and kill people behind the backs of politicians, that means that we have an expansion of the lobby platform. And then when professors' law become double spies on that same platform, we have more civil wars, especially due to all those lies. So this is the current situation, and we have a risk of new elections in the Netherlands. And that's a huge risk. You have no idea. Dutch politicians simply ignore the fact that our courts, bar associations and universities organize mass murder. Just when they come up with policies or laws, it's all half done work. It's irrelevant. The reality is much harder and more violent, and more civil war in Europe already, or more World War III internationally. Okay, then I learned that you want... No, first I have to say something about your own personal judicial position. You underestimate the evil, mister. And of course, you and I both assume that the Kremlin is not going to cause hell in your life suddenly. I think they keep you in Russia in 6 months' time. And they should. But you underestimate that lobby platform I described and the impact it has on you. Okay, it becomes clear that the American federal court admits that the NSA espionage activities are a criminal offense in relationship to the American Constitution. Okay. In the same second, Obama states, "I continue to spy," and the court looks away, or Obama simply establishes a new court that gives him right. So Obama is a very aggressive mass murderer in a sector, in a cloud behind the current media you can't see. It's all murder at the moment. Everybody is organizing murder against each other. Politicians killing each other, trying to kill each other. So there are talks about you being abducted, kidnapped or so. I think the Russian media should stop with it, because it makes people crazy, and there is already enough risk of war. You can't be kidnapped, or you can always defend yourself. For you, rules the same, namely, you have to tell the truth about your connection to me, the International Criminal Court, the torture treaty that protects you against Obama. You are not doing it at the moment because you protect the Kremlin. But I think there will be a day that you have to make a choice between yourself and the Kremlin, especially when Putin continues to create more mass murder. And that brings me to Brazil. Brazil, Latin America don't want to be helped. I feel deeply insulted by Evo Morales from Bolivia, because I asked asylum officially and they ignore me. That's a really criminal act. They simply close contracts with mass murderers for their businesses. Well, I try to reach them I try to inform the people about this criminal move of Bolivia, but it does show something. It shows that they don't care for justice, and they don't even care for sovereignty. And the same goes for Brazil. Brazil wants to have it all. They want to be friends with Putin, with Obama, and then they want to have self-protection. They want to be a state member of ICC. They are, but they don't want to work with human rights treaties. They are fine with the fact that ICC ignores the Statute of Rome and organizes a cover for mass murder organized via the European Union and the United Nations. They, Brazil, is a country that is indifferent towards its own sovereignty. And for that reason, you can't help them. As long as the people in Brazil are going to protest very hard the coming year against the Olympic Games, etc., there is no way you can help the government building sovereignty. They don't want it. They don't want justice. They don't want to be in charge of their own international law, their own evolution of intelligence. They have a president that should leave, but leave based on the truth, namely that the government of Brazil participates in creating mass murder because they want to be friends with everybody. I have saddened, haven't I? I feel so terrible. I can see that war in Europe increases. I have made a video for Ukraine. It's only watched 20 times, but I know that it's watched by a few people who do work with it and do appreciate it. So I hope Ukraine is going to put Europe next to Russia and next to all the criminal activities of politicians in Europe. I explain to them, so they will be able to rebalance themselves. But if they're not, they will go flat due to a civil war organized by both Russia and Europe via the ICC lobby platform. And then everybody goes flat because they are all deep linked to America, etc. So we have to wait. I feel so horrible. Every person I ask to help me turns into a mass murderer. And I see the war approaching. I can feel the chaos in every nano of my own existence. I'm not afraid of chaos, but it's so useless. For God's sake, it's so unbelievable useless. This God-forgotten planet is about to implode, and it's so low intelligent. Okay, think about what I have explained you here, and pay close attention to your own position on Earth. You are being a young person. I think there will be a day that you have to decide whether you put the torture treaty on your desk first or aid to other countries first. And I suggest you already start to build a framework for yourself based on the torture treaty and all my evidence and my explanations of the arrival of war. Okay, we're done for today. Goodbye.